And after the battering he and England took in October, he hasn't had much choice but to take this seriously. The result may not be the be-all and end-all tonight, but a vastly improved England performance is a must for the manager. It is, however, 37 years since England beat the Netherlands here. It wasn't in this stadium, it was on the old Olympic Stadium in Amsterdam. This state-of-the-art Amsterdam Arena has the roof open tonight, so the noise of the anthems will go up and into the night air over the Dutch capital. Round about 5,000 England supporters in a crowd of 45,000. It is a splendid arena. It's hosted Champions League finals. The semi-final of Euro 2000 was played here. And this is a proper friendly between sides ranked 4th and 7th by FIFA on their world list. And when the Dutch anthem booms out, you will hear a proper noise too. Crowd finished about 30 seconds before the singer. It's always a bit special to hear the Dutch anthem. Two around this arena at all sides. Well, like England, some high-profile names withdrew from the Dutch squad. Van Bronckhorst, Schneider and Van Persie are all out. Clarence Seedorf wins a first cap since the semi-final of Euro 2004. It's been all the talk in Amsterdam. Boularus, Oya, Lanzat, Robin and Kout all play in the Premiership, of course. Only Italy here in a friendly and Portugal in the World Cup have beaten Van Basten's side in 30 internationals. You will know by now that Micah Richards at 18 becomes England's youngest ever defender. Joe Cole plays for his country for the first time since the World Cup. And Andrew Johnson starts his first England game. The 5-3-2 of Zagreb has gone. Expect Johnson and Joe Cole to offer support to Rooney, who has been given license to roam. And England, by the way, start this friendly, having in the last few moments dropped to third place in their qualifying group for Euro 2008. The results tonight, Russia winning 2-0 in Macedonia, Croatia winning 4-3 in Israel, and that means that Croatia with 10 points top the group from Russia with 8. England have 7. That's all really for days ahead, Mark Lawrence. And what do we expect tonight?
Well, the performance in Croatia was abject at best. The system stroke formation didn't work. They're back to what they know best tonight, England. Boys in the studio said pace up from Johnson, Joe Cole back in, a little bit of guile in midfield, the passing of Carrick, and I would think a much improved performance. It is a performance more than a result tonight, which they got the England manager there in shot. I think that's the first thing that he'll be looking for, and if he gets also a good result, it will be a bonus.
This is England's last game of the calendar year. They have a friendly on the 7th of February against Spain. And then a tricky away game to Israel is the next qualifier, as Alan Shearer was saying. The referee is hugely experienced. Lubos Mikel took charge of the World Cup quarter-final in Berlin, the game between Germany and Argentina, and also of the Porto Celtic UEFA Cup final 3 years ago. It's England attacking the end away to the right-hand side in which their supporters are housed, and the Dutch in orange, white and blue. And here we go. No pressure then. Rio Ferdinand. First touch in international football, Micah Richards. And here's the Dutch captain tonight, it's the Blackburn defender, André Oyer. And the Chelsea defender, Boularus, gives it back to him. This is Emmanuelsen, it's his first start in the Dutch side. Ajax left back. Van der Vaart. Proper friendly mark, isn't it? Holland, England.
Yeah,
looks right.
Just the way England are set up, Steve, it looks a little bit more like 4-3-3 at the moment. Andy Johnson's virtually playing down the right-hand side, a combination of sort of down the right and inside right. I hope it doesn't stay that way.
This is Emmanuelsen. John Terry got his head to it. Dirk Kuyt is the central of the three players up front. Holland play 4-3-3. And this is Robin. And that's dangerously done. Michael Carrick was covering for England. Robin again. Sven Seedorf. Rio Ferdinand with the header. Now Andrew Johnson. It's a free kick.
Yeah, just to talk about Johnson again, we thought that he would be virtually up front on his own and Rooney would play off him. At the moment, that's certainly not happening. Joe Cole is also pushed, so it is 4-3-3 with England.
There's Johnson on that inside right channel looking to get his head onto the free kick, which he did. Gerrard couldn't reach the flick. His England debut at Villa Park against the Dutch. He ended up as a substitute playing on the right wing. That's Lanzaert, the Wigan midfielder. Ashley Cole. Carrick. Ashley Cole getting forward left-hand side. Found by Rooney. Just couldn't squeeze it through to Joe Cole. And Dirk Kuyt. Robin trying to get in behind, took John Terry, and then it took Micah Richards too.
Yeah, I think foul was given on John Terry. I think John Terry just came in to play the ball and was fouled on his way back.
It's a lovely ball though.
Yeah, it was just pushed off by the forward.
He's only played 29 times for Manchester City. But Steve McLaren was saying yesterday that, bearing in mind he knows very few of this England squad personally, so he only really knows Sean Wright Phillips from this squad, only knows him well, but he has not lacked confidence in training. Matthijssen for Holland.
He probably doesn't know what nerves are yet, Steve.
With the throw, once the spare ball had been poked away. Clarence Seedorf, it's a big night for him. Came off the back of Dirk Kuyt. Free kick. Richards on Kuyt. Taken already. Schaars finds Oya. Cole read it well. We've seen plenty of Ashley Cole getting forward down the left-hand side for England, and the slip from Carrick has let Clarence Seedorf in here. and Seydorf. Lampard's presence was enough. Seydorf lost his footing too, as Carrick had a moment before. Gerrard won't be hugging that right touchline, that's for sure. Carrick is looking for Johnson. Matthijssen is across. England have a throw. Carrick. Joe Cole gives up the lost cause.
Just that ball through to Johnson down the right-hand channel. If you notice it, he came out from the centre down there. He will do that naturally. And I think the worry is, if you sit him out there, it's very, very difficult for him. He's not used to coming in from out wide in central. It's the opposite way for him, which is, you know, first real start for England. It's a big ask of him.
Here's Oya. Matthijssen. Defoe couldn't get a foot on it. Rooney has. Richards. Ferdinand did well to find Johnson. That's an England throw. One thing Michael Richards certainly does have is a fantastic physique. There are many who think he might end up being a centre-half rather than a right-back. This is Henk Timmer in the Dutch goal. It's only his third cap at 34. It's taken him a while. Edwin van der Sar picks and chooses his friendlies these days and has decided he didn't fancy facing up against some of his club colleagues. Van der Vaart. Ashley Cole with him, three in the middle. Steven Gerrard's head has given Richard something to chase with Seydorf. Chase it he did. Emmanuelsson. Oh yeah. Kout came deep. Gerrard slid in with a challenge. And here's Johnson. Dutch throw. And every minute of all Holland's games in the World Cup, André Oyer. Given away three penalties, scored an own goal and had a red card for Blackburn. He came in the summer. It's Rooney. Tyson finds Timmer again. Oya gives it away. Andrew Johnson has Rooney to his left-hand side. Emmanuelsson chasing him. And in the end, I think Emmanuelsson got a touch on it.
I don't think Johnson, for any split second, had even a look at Wayne Rooney, and the ball was on to be played early after his first touch. Get your head up. Rooney was in a good position.
It's just basically a 4-3-3 mark, isn't it, that England are playing? Joe Cole wide left, Johnson wide right, and Rooney in the middle.
So the last three games, Steve, 4-4-2, 3-5-2, and now 4-3-3.
Touch free kick played up towards Dirk Kuyt. Robinson had to catch. It didn't come off Kuyt's head, it came off Terry's.
Terry just lost his boot, isn't he?
John Terry is just replacing his boot at the moment, so England have sat Michael Carrick in alongside Rio Ferdinand for the moment whilst they're down to 10. This is Stijn Schaars, the captain of Holland's under 21 side last summer, which won their European Championship. Robin. Van der Vaart is going to chase. And he's got there too when others might have given up. Credit to Van der Vaart. It's a decent ball too. Michael Richards was there. Dirk Kuyt trying to get underneath it. Carrick's clearance only found Oyek, Skars, Emanuelsson. Now for the first time, one side has a spell of pressure in that side of the Netherlands. It's Arjen Robben. And he's beaten Richards, hasn't beaten Robinson, Lanzaert!
Well, fortunately for England, I think it was the presence of Ashley Cole as the ball came off Robinson. It came up. Here's Robben. It's a little bit too much space. He's invited into the space. Decent shot. Ashley Cole here puts Lanzaert under pressure and he takes his eye off the header.
This is what Arjen Robben can do to you.
Part of the problem there, though, Steve, is that England was still waiting for John Terry to come on.
And he is back, John Terry. Now Johnson is fouled there by Mathijsen. England will be glad to have their skipper back on the field of play, and he's trotting forward for this free kick. And Stephen Gerrard is going to take. He may be the target. At the moment he's being closely watched by André Oyer. Referee is happy. Stephen Gerrard to take. Whatever it was, it didn't work.
Kind of betwixt and between, wasn't it? Just taking England a little bit of time to settle down here, what, into the 12th minute. The managers have been up by the touchline, has a little say. They certainly haven't got the ball down and started to pass it as yet.
There's Gerrard and Rooney to Johnson. It's a year and 3 days now since Wayne Rooney last scored for England.
Does that count in the stats as a shot, do you think?
Only if you're being generous, isn't it? Dirk Kuyt with Rio Ferdinand here. Ferdinand won it. Michael Richards' headers. Found Andrew Johnson. Stephen Gerrard. Chased Lanzaert, and he's going to chase the back pass from Bullerus. It's Gerrard for England! And Timo saves. Ran about 50 yards, Stephen Gerrard.
Well, I just wonder now, the benefit of hindsight, though, could have had another touch. It's a poor back pass, he was straight onto it. He had lots of time to take it on and commit the goalkeeper even more on his left foot as well. And in the end, the goalkeeper saved it with his backside.
Lanzaert clears the Gerrard cross. The Dutch are very fortunate to escape an awful back pass from Khalid Boularus. Came off Van der Vaart. I think they maybe needed a lift after the first 10 minutes or so, and that was nearly it.
Yeah, he scuffed it somewhat, didn't he? Stinking stomach, and another little touch, and got to go around the goalkeeper because he can't foul you. Well, he can, but we know what will happen then.
Has only scored once this season, Stephen Gerrard. He was more than prolific for a midfielder last season for Liverpool. Here he is. Good experience all around him, really, with Johnson in front and Richards behind. Richards has found Johnson. Here's Gerrard. Save off. It's a free kick to England in a dangerous position.
Clever play by Gerrard, wasn't it? Fainted to cross it, knocked it past Seydorf and bought the foul, basically.
And he's taken it too quickly. Too quickly. The flag was up.
It's a great ball in as well, this. He's offside.
Yeah, he's right. It's a correct flag.
Yeah. Good thinking on both parts, mind.
Tyson. Emanuelsson. Seydorf. Was part, of course, of the AC Milan team, Clarence Seydorf, which capitulated against Liverpool in Istanbul, inspired by Gerrard. Here's Emanuelsson and Rooney. It's a Dutch throw, despite Rooney's claims to the contrary. Dirk Kuyt's offside. He's a great favourite here, Dirk Kuyt, despite the fact that he used to be a fine old player, and there's not always a lot of love lost between Feyenoord and Ajax.
Well, there's one thing, Steve, everybody knows he has a very, very good technique, but he really does work hard for the team all the time.
Oh, yeah. Boularou's brave enough to try another back pass. Timo with a clearance. Seydorf there. Emanuelsson. Robin on the near side. Van der Vaart on the far. This is Robin. Came off Carrick. That's Dirk Kuyt. Ian Robin to Emanuelsson, who's found a bit of room and a dangerous cross. Well claimed by the goalkeeper. Van der Vaart was just half a yard away at the near post.
It's good play by Holland, but it's poor by England. Stevie Gerrard lets the man run. The left back puts in a decent cross as well, which Robinson has to deal with.
Joe Cole gets ahead on the ball. I can't remember Joe Cole having a touch in the previous 17 minutes. Here's Carrick, Rooney. John Terry. Terry Fringler, and it was cut out by Lanza. Not sure where to go. So he looks to Terry. Rooney very deep. Lampard's made a forward run. Oh, first touch. That was an enormously difficult ball to take first time, but had he would have had a real opportunity.
The other thing as well is that the Dutch goalkeeper, Timo, just was rooted to his line, and really, the ball travelled so far, he could have come and claimed it very easily.
Matthijssen. Skaars. Emanuelsson. Ferdinand's header covered well. This is Gerrard. Not an awful lot of pace about the game, is there?
No, there isn't. Rather messy, rather scrappy and tidy. And also, both teams giving the ball away.
Well, Seydorf there got his foot in ahead of Michael Carrick. He's got it back. And Seydorf! Nice little one-touch movement, Clarence Seydorf right at the heart of it. Van der Vaart involved.
Yeah, it's bright play, but it's going to be some strike from this distance to beat Robinson. It'll give and go.
Well, you'd like to think so. Terry Venables trying to get a better view of things. Who could forget Euro 96, England 4, Holland 1. Sagal forward. Van der Vaart couldn't take it in his stride. England will have a throw-in. Ashley Cole will take this throw-in. It's fair to say that Micah Richards so far has found out a little bit more about Arjen Robben, but look at the confidence of the full-back here, Chad Gerrard. Joe Cole coming inside to get involved. Andrew Johnson was offside anyway, according to the assistant down on this near side.
That's a position though, isn't it? Just splitting the two centre-backs, running in the back of them.
Well, you can bet your bottom dollar that neither Oya nor Matteson would catch him.
No chance.
Rooney has found Carrick and Johnson's looking to move off the shoulder of the defender. Steven Gerrard involved. Rooney again for England. Joe Cole. And Lampard. And Lampard again, and Oya with a clearance.
I think that was England's best piece of football. They were moving all over the place. Cole came over on the right, Lampard got himself in a great position. Pass and move at its best, really.
Micah Richards takes the throw, Andrew Johnson. Kout. Van der Vaart is very tight. Three Dutch forwards were within about 2 yards of each other. Steven Gerrard has found Joe Cole. And I think has come inside just in an attempt to get involved in the game. Dirk Kout's onside here. Beaten to it by Robinson. Ferdinand doesn't take any chances. The Dutch have taken a quick throw.
Well, Robinson did well in dealing with the ball over the top. I thought it was a foul on Joe Cole, but Robinson did extremely well here, was always going to win that particular race. Joe Cole was just knocked over by the defender.
It's Oya. Van der Vaart, lovely turn, Ferdinand there. Terry did just enough, didn't he, to hold it up. Navarre is something of an enigma. He's a player who at Ajax as a teenager looked like one of the best that Dutch had ever produced. Hasn't quite lived up to that. He's now playing at Hamburg. Got halfway through the first half without either side really threatening to score. Robinson made a smart save from Robben and Lanzarte put the rebound wide. Robben might just get to this. Well, give him his dues, he made every effort to.
That came from England's goal kick from Robinson, where he rolled it out and whacked it upfield. And really, nobody, Johnson's not going to win the ball in the air, certainly Rooney and Joe Cole aren't. And a little bit more cuter England, I think, in terms of distribution.
Header from Matteson, kept in by Robben, saved off. Dutch throw. Terry's header. England's free kick. Joe Cole knocked over by Boularus. Carrick. Lampard, Johnson was just a little quicker over the first couple of yards than Emanuelsson. Has to keep it in, though, and he didn't.
No, he also didn't really have any help, did he? Is it my imagination? Everybody ran away when he got the ball in the corner.
The look on his face said it all as well. He didn't look terribly happy. Belarus to Mathiasen, the player who replaced him in Hamburg when Belarus went to Chelsea. Oh yeah, decent ball, Ian Robin. Well done, Michael Richards. Robin's had the better of him once or twice, but he stuck to his job well there, Richards.
Well, he did as well, because it was one against one, and a bit like Johnson at the other end, Michael Richards didn't have too much help.
Clarence Seedorf. Van der Vaart back into Seedorf, to Van der Vaart! Now, that would have been a goal.
Yeah, that was clever play, but have you noticed from the throw-in, straight to Seedorf, nobody picked him up. Clever interplay as well.
He's in a terrific position there, Van der Vaart, and he got the shot all wrong. Clarence Seedorf was actually part of that Dutch squad beaten at Wembley by England, famously in 96. Mathiasen with a header, Gerrard. Going nowhere. Well, Steven Gerrard very nearly made the most of Bularu's effort, but apart from that, you wouldn't say England had really created an opportunity. John Terry. Decision goes England's way. It was Lanzard and Lampard. Is it handball? It's Rooney. Joe Cole. Ashley Cole is forward too. Needed to stay in play, and it did. And it might come for Rooney! Thought about letting it drop for a volley, then decided to head it. Timmer saves.
Yeah, decent ball in. And it's Johnson who causes the panic in the penalty. I think there are three Dutch players around him. In the end, when the ball comes to Rooney, you think you've got time to have a touch. Obviously doesn't know. In the end, it's an easy save for Timmer.
Well, that was better. Dutch have a free kick here. Last score for England in the pre-World Cup friendly in Switzerland against Argentina. Big surprise that Van Basten brought Seedorf back. Only a week or so ago he was saying that's not a route I want to go down, but Wesley Sneijder got injured here playing for Ajax against PSV on Sunday, and back Seedorf came, not just into the squad, into the team. Here he is.
Wouldn't that be a bit like Beckham coming back for England?
Very much so. Belarus. Van der Vaart. Robin. Seedorf has spotted the run of Emanuelsson. So is Andrew Johnson, who's got a cross. Michael Richards away. Nobody up there, though. Oya had a little look to see where Rooney was. Wasn't the greatest clearance in the world. Frank Lampard has it for England. Andrew Johnson here. Mathiasen struggling slightly to get across. Johnson, no one there.
Yeah, just a little bit of chasing lost cause, isn't it?
Stijn Schaars here. Belarus. Lanzard. just kept in by Emanuelsson. You can say either side are playing blisteringly well at the moment.
Well, we're told that there's no real pressure on this game, and yet when you look at both teams, they're playing with lots of pressure, aren't they?
Holland topped their qualifying group for Euro 2008, started this season with a 4-0 win in Ireland. Here's Robin. Ferdinand away. It's met by Schaars, who tried to find Lanzat, and Lampard is in there for England, and Joe Cole is to his left-hand side, and Rooney is there, and Cole's furthest forward, and it's cut out by Bularus. And here's Van der Vaart, and Bularus has continued his run. Dirk Kuyt for Holland. Bularus just too short. Bularus gets it back. Van der Vaart, decent strike, but Robertson knew where it was headed.
Now again, it's another effort from distance. Kuyt as well in the end. It's very comfortable from England that.
Robin van Persie certainly would have played in this game, except for his wife being about to give birth. And van Persie, in the five games Holland have played this season, has scored five times, so he is a big miss for them. That's fairly heavily in the favour of the Netherlands. Here's Van der Vaart, John Terry across. Claimed that it had gone out of play. Terry almost gave it away. Ashley Cole has almost done the same. Rio Ferdinand just kept it away from Robin. And Schaars just got ahead of Gerrard.
Yeah, England a little bit fortunate. Oh, yeah, Robin didn't really fancy it when he looked at Rio Ferdinand, did he? I think he was always going to be second in that tackle.
Dutch needed an own goal to beat Albania here in their last match. 2-1. Here's Rooney. Lanzat, Kuyt to his right. Robins joined Van der Vaart on the edge of the England penalty area. Dirk Kuyt finds Van der Vaart. Not sure that his flick didn't take it away from Robin slightly.
Don't commit too many men forward, do they, Dutch? I think on that occasion, just two, and England had at least four back.
Oyer's head, Seedorf, Robin. Schaars finds Seedorf. It's a poor ball.
Oh, it's catching, isn't it? You have the ball, you give it to us, and we'll give it right back to you.
Cole. Ashley Cole. Johnson, Joe Cole in the middle, Lampard in the middle. And the touch just came off Denny Lanzat on its way through to Timmer. England really playing without a target man, Mark.
Yeah, slight problem, and especially when you're not passing the ball particularly well. And the idea, if you're not playing with a target on, is to keep it and wait for the movement.
Robin. Went the way of the Netherlands. And Dirk Kuyt lost out to Joe Cole. This is Michael Carrick. Free kick. And just a word from referee Mr. Mikel into the ear of Lanzat. No free kick. Steven Gerrard here. It's a clever ball into Rooney, and Lampard and Micah Richards was there too, and Timber has got it away.
Yeah, it's better play, Gerrard, in that central position. Picks Rooney out, lovely run by Rooney. They're unlucky here, England. Slight hint of desperation by Timber.
Micah Richards there must have thought he was about to mark his England debut with a goal.
I think you made the point before about Arjen Robben. Arjen Robben's not going to chase him all day.
Joe Cole for England. It's a corner. He's looking at the big screen, McLaren. Doesn't look a picture of contentment. Lampard is going to take the corner. That was Ferdinand's head. Here's Boularus. Marco van Basten with John van Schip on the dugout, his assistant taking notes. Johnson, Gerrard, Joe Cole, Andrew Johnson in the middle, Lampard two. Cole, that's a lovely ball, and Rooney is there! It's a release for Wayne Rooney, it's his first England goal in more than a year. And it was a fabulous ball in from Joe Cole.
You can't understate the run from Richards as well here, Steve. Look, just takes the defender away, lets Cole deliver it in, which is an excellent pass, and Rooney does well almost with the back of his boot, but Richards' overlap made all the difference to Cole, gave him half a yard in which to pick out Rooney.
Tremendous delivery. I think we'll put that down as a very clever finish from Wayne Rooney.
Oh, no doubt about that.
And England are in front. And Tyson almost lost out to Joe Cole there. England have missed Joe Cole. He's not been available to Steve McLaren at all.
And arguably in the last 5 to 10 minutes when he's played on the right, it looked a little bit different, didn't he?
Here's Robin. That came off Ferdinand, and now Holland have a throw. Arjen Robben will take. It's over Oya, and it's Wayne Rooney with the headed clearance. It's only his third international goal, Rooney, since the European Championships in Portugal. Andrew Johnson furthest forward. Ashley Cole's made a terrific run. Might get there too, Boularus. It's Andrew Johnson, just beaten to it. Lanzart recovered well. It's a new buzz about England since the goal. Robin, oh, that's a free kick. Not happy about that, they're not happy at all about that.
Well, I think it looked for me as though Cal jumped at John Terry and just tried to knock him out of the way. Here's a goal. The run of Richards, great ball from Joe Cole, that sort of corridor of uncertainty, and excellent finish by Rooney. The first real quality football from England of the half.
And it is great to see him back in the goals, Rooney. He's only scored against Denmark and Argentina since the two against Croatia in Euro 2004. And he's added now one against the Dutch. It's his 12th international goal on the occasion of his 36th cap. 1 in 3 at international level. I think most would take that. Seedorf. Emanuelsson. Count. Count to chase. He'll settle for a throw. He knew it came off Richards.
I think also, Steve, looking at the goal, because of the fact that Crouch isn't in there, and not be crying in, but it's, people then have got to make a different run, haven't they? It's just easy, if you're the crosser, just to stand it up for Crouch and say, go on there, fight for that and see if you can get something from it. And the quality of the cross made the goal, basically.
Matthijssen for Holland. Robin. Carrick was there. Richards has lost out here. Ian Robin. Micah Richards chasing. Good pace too. He's pulling at Robin's shirt though. The referee was well aware of the foul.
It's a pity really, because he's stronger. Richards is far stronger than Robin, as we know. And first, it's Robin, I think, pulling Richards' shirt.
This is a moment of danger for England. Clarence Seedorf and Ian Robin are over the free kick. Matthijssen, Kaut, Skars and Oya are inside the penalty area. There's a deflection on it. Kaut back into the danger area. Ferdinand out of it. And Lampard has found help from Carrick. Kaut starting it to Oya. Oh, went through Joe Cole to Robin. Clarence Seedorf here. Wayne Rooney way back on the edge of his own penalty area. Dirk Kaut. Ian Robin. Scars to Oya. Boularus. Lots of white shirts back behind the ball here for England. Half-time's only 2.5 minutes away. It's a lovely ball. Ferdinand got ahead on it. Boularus is there. It wasn't a good ball in, really, by Boularus, but it's come back to him via Schaas. Oya. Robin. Emanuelsson. Seedorf. Van der Vaart. Oh, well nicked away by Ashley Cole. Lampard. Matthijssen to Seedorf. Dirk Kaut. Decent ball in, well taken by Paul Robinson, well played by Kaut. It's Van der Vaart who was just in front of the England goalkeeper. Here's Joe Cole, who had such a big say in England's goal. Boularus. Suffered the indignity, didn't he, at White Hart Lane the other week of being brought on at half-time by Jose Mourinho, only to be taken off again about 20 minutes later. Robbie Keane had done the damage. Van der Vaart.
You feel with the Dutch front three, don't you? Van der Vaart, Kaut and Robin. Very much playing in front of England. And not really, none of the three are running in behind Ferdinand and Terry. And at the moment for England, it's easy to defend against.
And no one's getting beyond either from the Dutch midfield.
No.
And that's the end of a first half in which England have a very encouraging lead. Wayne Rooney's first international goal in over 12 months, getting on to the end of an excellent ball in by Joe Cole. It's a wonderful cross and it's a clever finish, this by Rooney. We've all been saying it's the performance, not the result, that matters, but England would take this result. Half-time in the Amsterdam Arena. It's the Netherlands 0, England 1.
Well, it's not been pretty most of the time, but England lead at half-time, so that'll be a boost for the confidence.
Well, it will be, and the big thing, a big talking point is the system. I said at the top, hopefully he'll go with a system that players are familiar with, they play week in, week out. He didn't do that. He went three up front, Rooney through the middle, Johnson on the right and Cole on the left. Johnson's been basically hung out to dry. He doesn't play that position. And for 35 minutes, even though you could argue that England had probably the better chances with Gerrard and Wayne Rooney, it was bitty and disjointed. Then he put Johnson through the middle. You get Joe Cole on the right-hand side, picks up, bit of pressure on the defence, great ball in the box, it's a goal, and it's a different story.
England did look effective for about 5 minutes in that half, and it was the time when Johnson played down the middle.
He must be very, very frustrated, Andy Johnson, because for the most part of this season, he's played down the middle for Everton, on his own at times with James Beattie. But he's been on the right, isolated. We've even seen him in the right back position, defending, which obviously he wouldn't want to do, but is willing to do for the team. And ironically, he changes it after 36 or 37 minutes and pushes Andy Johnson down the middle, Rooney to the left of him, and Joe Cole to the right of him, and that's when the goal came.
Yeah, it was a strange formation to go with, but here is the goal, Rooney's goal, and you'll see Johnson involved.
Well, I think that Michael Richards does really well. You see him on the right-hand side, great overlap here. Just gives Joe Cole that little bit of space and time. Great ball into the box.
Great ball.
Fantastic. Just waiting to be buried. And Wayne Rooney comes in, and it's a competent finish.
It's the ball in between the goalkeeper and the defender.
Difficult to defend.
And they just don't know what to do with the defence. And it's really the only sort of cross that is coming for the forwards. And Johnson and Rooney are in the box, really, together for the first time. Rooney gets there before Johnson and sticks it away very well.
Here's the run by Richards. He's not in a picture. And Gerrard picks it up. But he's coming. And he's strong, he's quick. And he gets there and just gives that little bit of time to Joe Cole. But the delivery of this ball is absolute perfection. So difficult to defend against. Needs a touch from attacker or defender. And it comes from Wayne Rooney. It's in the back.
I said before the game, the more Micah Richards can do that and get beyond the winger, Andy Johnson, Joe Cole, or whether it be Rooney, Robin ain't going to chase him. You seen the picture there. Robin was nowhere to be seen. He isn't going to defend.
Okay. Prior to that, England's best chance fell due to a nice pass back into the path of Steven Gerrard.
Well, it was absolutely horrific, the pass back, and Steven Gerrard could not believe how much time and space he had. He does really well here, Gerrard, because he's picked up there, played it, and he just keeps on going. And going and going, and the keeper doesn't come, he's through it. He could take another touch, but he decides to hit it first time with his left foot. I think he should take another touch there and get it onto his right and just
yeah.
Put it.
I think he can actually go around the ball to hit it with his right foot. It's easy to sit there and say because he's missed it, if it got under the keeper's legs and he's done the right thing, but he has all the time in the world. He could have took either side of him, left or right, takes it early. Good save by the goalkeeper in the end.
Tremendous perseverance to just keep on going and going and going.
Wayne Rooney, he's got his goal, which is important because he scored too many of late for England. Good for his confidence. Prior to that, he missed a real chance where he, too, a little bit like Steven Gerrard, seemed to rush it, fraction.
I actually think he could have volleyed it, he could have taken a touch. Look, there's no one within 5 yards of him there. Could have easily took a touch, have confidence, right or left.
I think he does really well here just to sit back. He just takes a step back here and lets Andy Johnson go for it.
Look, there's no one around him. There's no one at all. He can take a touch, he can volley it. He takes the wrong option.
It's a golden opportunity.
Yeah, we saw Wayne Rooney playing through the middle most of the time, out and out, which when you've got a player like Rooney who likes to drop deep, that's tantamount to not playing any strikers at all when you've got Johnson on the right and Cole on the left. I mean, we've got quite a few examples of the way England were trying to shape up.
Well, what you're doing is you're playing two of the three out of position there. You know, Andy Johnson doesn't play there, Wayne Rooney doesn't. You tell me Wayne Rooney's best position is just off the front man. Andy Johnson's best position is through the middle, Wayne Rooney playing that ball through to him around the corner. I mean, if you look at the lineup here, Al.
There's the shape there. There's Andy Johnson on the right hand side, Rooney down the middle, Joe Cole on the left. That's 4-3-3. It's not 4-5-1 or 4-4-2, 4-3-3.
But the thing about that is, what you've just said is right. The man in the middle there, Wayne Rooney, 9 times out of 10 will come short.
Yeah.
So then when there was times when Rio Ferdinand was picking up, he's not got anybody to hit.
There's Andy Johnson again there, right-hand side. I mean, how many times do you ever see him out in that position for Everton? I mean, they're kicking the ball out there for him to go and head it. I mean, that's not his job. He actually wants to run onto things. He doesn't want to be the one that's heading it.
He doesn't want to play there. You know, you can see in the frustration and the end.
It's been a
I mean, he's done well in actual fact because he hasn't complained. But this would sum up the frustration. That position, just have a look at the facials here.
I think that tells its own little story.
Exactly.
As Al said, he'll run all day for you because he's that type of player. But you're not really going to see the best of him. Here we have him in the right back position, defending. We get the ball here, we've got no one to hit up front. We end up giving it straight back to them, inviting them on for another attack because both Rooney and in particular Johnson are defending.
What is it about Andy Johnson against the Dutch? Because the last time he played, I mean, this sums up here. It's somebody should be crossing it for him to be running into the ball. Nobody comes into the picture whatsoever.
You need to be very good to cross it to yourself.
This is when Andy Johnson goes through the middle. We've scored the goal. They put him through the middle. This is what he wants. This is what he wants to do. He wants to run onto things. That's where I think you see the best of Andy Johnson. That's where he's a threat and he's going to cause problems.
It's hard enough to play in international football without playing your best position.
Why do you think he played this way then? Because, I mean, it's pretty obvious that Rooney likes to drop deep and Johnson likes to play in the middle. What?
Well, I think he showed against the Croatians that, you know, the lineup against the Croatians, he tried to be clever with it in the lineup. I think he's been trying to be clever again and play a different way maybe. But every manager I've ever played for, like, if you had any problem whatsoever, play simple. Keep it simple. Play to your strengths. Play your best players in your best positions, and don't be clever.
I don't think it's. I think it's frustrating for Andy. He's doing the job. But you know what Steve McLaren will say? He'll say, "Well, hang on a minute. We've won the first half."
Which is a fair comment. Yeah. They're a goal up.
Andy've had 2 or 3 chances. We're just pointing out the frustrations of Andy because he's not used to playing that way, and judging by that, he doesn't like playing that way.
Well, you can make a case for that system, but you'd probably just juggle them around.
Well, I would if it was going to play that, I would play Andy in the middle.
Yeah.
So he's the one that's running onto things and
give
Rooney
you a bit more
and
Cole
either side of him, because that's the way really he plays for Everton. That's where he scored most of his goals.
Yeah.
Alan, he's a great player through the middle.
As a defender, what do you make of Micah Richards' debut?
I think he's done really well. We mentioned the run for the goal. I think defensively against Robin, he had his problems early on. We pick him up here at the bottom of your picture. He just lets Robin run past him, and if the ball's played in now into that area, then he's away. But what he does well here is that doesn't affect him, and he keeps on going, and eventually the person that's making the tackle is Richards. He keeps on going, keeps getting back. He's got a little bit of pace. He's tenacious here, times this to perfection. That's a great tackle, and I think he's coming to a really, really good game. England build up here is quite good. They've got possession of the ball, and when it eventually comes to them, the pass isn't great, but I sympathise with him in this position, because if you look forward here, I don't think he's got much to hit. You know, he tries to chip it in here, you look forward here, nothing to hit there whatsoever. Defensively, I think this is a great header under pressure. Great ball in, he's coming there.
Great position.
Great position. All right, he's gone up there, but he's gone up there a long way, so England can readjust. This would worry me slightly.
He's bound to be a bit green, I mean, he's only 18.
Yeah, well, this is 18. This, he probably doesn't get tight enough, quick enough here. He's played into Robin, played back, and he's facing the wrong way here. For some reason, I don't know why. He just gets himself in a bad position there. I mean, that has been really, really critical of the boy, because I think he's done it exceptionally well. What he's done, he's come outside, come inside, but he's stuck with him. And that really is good defending against what you've got to point as a top-class player. Top-class
strong.
I think he's done really well.
And I think as you'd expect,
it's gone on, it's got stronger and stronger.
Just going to say, as you'd expect for someone of his age on a debut, the longer the half's gone on, he's got better and better.
So a number of positives. Let's pause briefly to tell you about a few programmes coming up on BBC One.
You're innocent, so the evidence must be flawed. It's our job to find those flaws.
Your time will be better spent on another case.
I don't know if I'm up for this. Putting it right when the law gets it wrong. The Innocence Project, tomorrow at 8 on BBC One.
Is there someone else who needs this execution to take place?
You get me out of here.
The State Within. Tomorrow at 9 on BBC One.
BBC Children in Need is coming. Whole night of outrageously fabulous live entertainment, BBC Children in Need, this Friday from 7 on BBC One.
Speaking of big nights, it's that time of the year when we start looking forward to this.
Andrew Freddy Flintoff. It's the biggest sporting honour your country can give you.
The Lifetime Achievement Award to Pelé. The award goes to Jose Mourinho.
Of course, it's a great honour for me.
And the winner is Johnny Wilkinson.
Difficult to explain, really, how this feels. Personality of the year, Wayne Rooney.
I'm just really very pleased indeed. Thank you very much.
All around it. Was and he is the sports personality of the century, Muhammad Ali.
It's a great privilege to receive this award.
David Beckham.
I have to thank everyone, you know, all the viewers for voting.
Performance from Andrew Murray.
I think it's the best performance of any British rider in boxing.
Suddenly she realises that she is European and world champion.
Jenson Button wins. A great drive by Cock.
Monty Panesar
is bowling.
Ernie McCoy, 10 times champion.
That's it, the channel.
The dream for Beth Tweddle is now a reality.
So many emotions.
Few weeks yet, but start thinking about it. More football to look forward to at the weekend. All starts with Focus on Saturday lunchtime at 12:10. Then at 2:30 on Interactive, there's Score, joined by BBC One at 4:30. Some great-looking games in store for Match of the Day on Saturday night, BBC One 10:25. And round the weekend off with Match of the Day 2, Sunday, BBC Two at 10. Well, England are playing a friendly tonight, but there have been a couple of Group E European Championship qualifiers played that have affected England's position in the table. Croatia now top the group, having followed up victory over England with a 4-3 win in Israel. Brazilian-born striker Eduardo da Silva scored a hat-trick for the visitors, and Russia's first away match of the campaign ended with a 2-0 win in Macedonia. So they knock England down to third in the table, and it's looking awfully tight and tense and a long way to go, I know, but a bit to do.
England are still going to qualify. Players are too good not to qualify. And I think that the confidence that they can gain out of this match will set them back on track. And, you know, we keep on looking at the lineup and thinking, this is a great lineup. They've got great players. And it'd be a travesty if they didn't qualify for Euro 2020.
Just sets that Israel game up nicely, doesn't it, in March?
Not long to wait for that one at all. But, I mean, it's a tough group. It's a tougher group than it looked at the start, yeah, because other sides are performing well and England have had that wobbly
start. It's a tougher group now than it should have been because of the last result against Croatia. But I still think they'll have enough to qualify.
Okay, that, you know, we've talked about a number of matches that are taking place tonight that do count, European Championship qualifiers. Here are one or two in Group D. Germany being held by Cyprus. Balak scored for Germany to put them ahead, but Cyprus have equalised. It's half-time there, and good performance so far from the Republic of Ireland, although we must remember it's only little San Marino. They're 2-0 ahead, and that's the latest score. What we're looking for in the second half, more of the same, or
I think that the performance can improve, the passing and the movement. The intrigue for me is if he makes changes, will it just be personnel or will it be the system? Will he go with a different system when he brings people on? You might look for Sean Wright Phillips or Richardson to come on wide. But again, after 15, 20 minutes, will this man eventually go through the middle?
That sort of goal should give the side a bit of confidence, because they'll feel that criticism that has been.
Oh, absolutely, yeah, and they've been criticised, and rightly so, because of their performance. But as you say, every little bit helps. And playing like they have done, more importantly, getting into half time leading in a tough place, not necessarily against a great Dutch team here, but they're winning. That's at this moment in time, that's enough, and they'll take little things from that.
Yeah, the Dutch aren't brilliant, but it's still a hard place to come to and win, and if they win this match, then the confidence level will start going up again, and that's what's most important about this game.
Okay, see what happens in the second half with Mark Lawrenson and Steve Wilson.
Well, talking about changes, there's only actually one change at half time, and that's it. In goal for Holland, Martin Stekelenburg replaces Henk Timmer. That's the Ajax goalkeeper replacing the Feyenoord goalkeeper in Ajax's home stadium. And like Timmer, he's winning his third cap. He was unused at the World Cup just gone by. England, no changes at half-time. The facts of the matter are that Holland have lost only once on home turf in 3 years. So this would be a significant scalp for England, who lead 1-0. Kicking from right to left in the second half. Changes will, of course, come throughout the second period, as is always the way in friendlies. But at the moment, England, as they were in the first half. Matthijssen forward for the Netherlands to Seedorf. And Robin ran out of pitch, so England have a throw. Your view on Michael Richards, Mark, first half?
Yeah, so far so good, to be honest with you. 18 years of age. What did you know about anything at 18, let alone football?
Not impossible, by the way, that we might see another new cap if Ben Foster should come on for England to replace Paul Robinson at some point. Chris Kirkland, who came on for England in the home friendly against Greece. We should offer him our congratulations, because he's just become father to a baby girl. England with 10 on the bench. Kieran Richardson in the middle there, and initially dropped to the under-21s, who won last night in Alkmaar. And recalled to the squad because 8 of Steve McLaren's initial squad, which was huge, dropped out. Here's Joe Cole. Offside flag went up eventually against Andrew Johnson.
Yeah, Cole starting down the right, Steve. Just really, I think, we're looking to see what the Dutch do, if anything. They've gone in at half-time and Van Basten will have had words with them, no doubt. See whether they raise the tempo. They were extremely low-key even after England took the lead in the first half.
I always think the Dutch with Schneider are better than the Dutch without Schneider, and Schneider's not here today. He's such a driving force in midfield for them.
Yeah, man, you can argue. Hargreaves, Michael Owen.
Oh, England are...
Aaron Lennon.
England are missing all sorts. Aaron Lennon would have played in this game had he not been withdrawn by Tottenham Hotspur. England's front three are shaping up with Andrew Johnson on the left and Joe Cole over there on the right. Rio Ferdinand with the header. Scars gave it away badly to Joe Cole. Seedorf flew in with a challenge. Took it cleanly. Emanuelsson, the left back. Referee lets play go on, and this is Van der Vaart for Holland.
Well, we've got a new from the crowd, but he could have thrown his cap on it, Robinson.
Rooney pulled out, Matthijssen was there, it's Seedorf. Ooh, nearly from Dirk Kuyt. He's covered some yards down this side. Ashley Cole for England tonight. Dirk Kuyt. Lanzat, carefully done. Micah Richards, cleverly overstayed off. Joe Cole back into trouble. Robin with the 1-2, Dirk Kuyt waited, Ashley Cole didn't. Dirk Kuyt looks around, and Robin in particular said, I could have done with a shout there. Emanuelsson, he's beaten Joe Cole. Seydorf, Robin wants it this near side, that's where it's heading. Now Boularus, who is a flick onto Seydorf! Well, Michael Carrick waved his foot at it, Seydorf didn't.
Yeah, all Carrick really did was divert it at pace, straight to Seydorf, hit it very, very early, and with this tried and trusted left foot, you thought it might have hit the target. A little bit of a let off for England.
Was a chance. Carrick forward. Now Tyson with the header, Seydorf is there. Really might have chased that had Matthijssen not got in the way. A point he's making to the referee's assistant.
Matthijssen was clever, just made sure, didn't he, that he bulked Wayne Rooney.
Bit of room here. That's not a great task.
We know Robin's quick, and he ain't that quick.
Terribly animated at the moment, but it's been a long, hard day in Amsterdam for some of them. There's plenty to do. You couldn't argue with a win against the Dutch in Amsterdam, that is for sure. England against Spain, early February, is the next friendly. Then England in Israel, who, to remind you, lost 4-3 at home to Croatia today. This is Van der Vaart. Skaars. Gerrard got a foot in. The Dutch will have a throw. Rooney. There were breakers immediately ahead of Rooney. It's Lampard and Joe Cole. Matthijssen was there. England were in, had he not been. John Terry is favourite there and safely gets it behind for an England goal kick. Not quite a full house, but not far off. Worth pointing out that Gary Neville, who is obviously still the first pick at right back for England, has played in only 8 of the last 22 international matches. So some sort of backup is a necessity, because in recent times Gary Neville has missed more than he's played. Andrew Johnson with Boularus. Robin, Emanuelsson, careless, England have a throw.
There is a real lack of urgency about this Dutch team, isn't there?
Well, we talk about England having a friendly here in which they have to perform well. I mean, the Dutch at the moment are really not offering very much at all. It's Lanzar. And they did have that narrow victory over Albania here, which hardly would have set tongues wagging. 2-1 against Albania, thanks to an own goal.
Well, the other thing, Steve, is that the last three balls that the Dutch have played forward, which is basically given to England.
Here's Robin. Joe Cole. Richards. Robinson won't be unhappy with that clearance. Here's Robin, no Dirk Kuyt that's ahead of him. Van der Vaart also inside the penalty area. Carrick stood firm. There was an appeal for handball, actually, which was waved away. This is Emmanuelsson. Oya. Lanzat. Boularouz. Block challenged by Carrick. That's given away by Carrick to Boularouz. Ian Robin. Little one-twos with Robin and Van der Vaart. Good block by Rio Ferdinand. It's an excellent piece of defending. Van der Vaart's looking for handball, but it was a great block by Ferdinand. And England have a free kick here.
Yeah, foul on Joe Cole. And Seedorf having a word with the referee. Ferdinand just got himself in the way, basically. Very, very brave. And surely can't give handball for that. Just in there for the block. No. Came off the back of his leg onto his hand. Absolutely no chance.
Matthijssen is there. It's not great. It's Gerrard into Rooney. Lands out for the Dutch. Van der Vaart. Joe Cole. There's Matthijssen. Ashley Cole knew what he was doing. Lampard. Ashley Cole. Andrew Johnson furthest forward. Lampard has joined him. Cole looks in field. Carrick is there. First time to Rooney. Now Gerrard. Lots of space on the England right-hand side. Joe Cole. Three on the edge of the Dutch penalty area. Well, he's delivered one absolute peach. That wasn't another.
I was going to say, not too dissimilar from this, from the position, was it? And the overlapping run, this time from Gerrard rather than Micah Richards. Just the quality of the cross, not good.
So there's been pressure on Steve McLaren at times to bring back David Beckham from Real Madrid. David Beckham isn't really playing much for Real Madrid, but Ruud van Nistelrooy can't stop scoring for Real Madrid. Van Basten continues to ignore him. I think that relationship between those two has just broken down completely.
Yeah, from the World Cup, wasn't it? He scored four at the weekend. Van Nistelrooy, I think.
Yeah. It's careless, really. At the moment, England are very comfortable. Not brilliant, but comfortable. Carrick. Ashley Cole. Johnson lost out to Boularouz. Fairly says the referee. Steins Haas here. Counterway to the left-hand side. Robin down the middle. Boularouz wants it long across the face of the penalty area. Kuyt ignores him, looks for room himself. And overran it in the end. Was chased all the way by Joe Cole.
Yeah, he was looking for the Roy the Rovers goal, wasn't he?
Boularouz has been left in the heat by Lampard. This is Rooney. Joe Cole for England. Oh yeah, just there. Mr. Kellenberg with the clearance. The referee rightly stops play. Boularouz is the man down.
I think he's twisted his knee, Steve, in the tackle. There's anything wrong with the tackle. There's no malice in the tackle. It's just the way the tackle happened. Yeah, just dangled a leg and he's probably tweaked his knee, I would have thought.
Now, Boularouz gets treatment, and meantime, there is activity over on the far side of the ground, in the dugouts, and this is Klaas-Jan Huntelaar of Ajax. who scored twice in the final of the under 21 European Championships in the summer, just missed out on the World Cup final squad, made his debut at Lansdowne Road just after, scored twice, was the European Golden Boot scorer last season when he scored for Heerenveen, joined Ajax halfway through the season. And Huntelaar, who is very highly rated, has 12 in 18 for Ajax so far this season. And it looks like Dirk Kuyt is the man who is going to make way for Huntelaar. Boularus, meantime, has been asked to leave the field of play after his lengthy treatment. Seen much of Huntelaar?
I have to say to you, nothing. Not that I can remember, anyway.
No, well, he's... he is very, very highly rated. Boularus is back on, but for how long remains to be seen. Stekelenburg, the Ajax goalkeeper, the Ajax and Dutch goalkeeper, takes the clearance. Andrew Johnson. Ashley Cole. Boularus in. Lansaert forward. Terry is there. Ferdinand. Mathijsen got a foot in. Joe Cole working hard for England. Dutch will have a throw. The changes might just happen first. The other change, Boularus is going to be replaced as well. Dirk Kuyt makes his way. Kuyt Jellens will come on for Boularus. We're at the hour mark, which is when the substitutions normally start happening.
Yeah, well, Kuyt, obviously, Huntelaar for Kuyt is tactical. Boularus is not worth running the risk of getting further injury, is it?
So three from Van Basten, none yet from England. Oh yeah, forward. Lampard just got there. Willow's touch changes, disrupt or inspire. Schaars, Rio Ferdinand is there. Joe Cole for England, cleverly to Gerrard, chased by Seedorf. Well played, England. Oh, Joe Cole just showed too much to Mathijsen. Carrick will get there first. Ashley Cole here. Carrick. No free kick. Joe Cole surely has a case. Mathijsen seemed to come through from behind him. Huntelaar is offside.
Yeah, this will be interesting for Ferdinand and Terry. This guy is prepared to run the other side of the two central defenders. Whereas Kuyt really, Steve, is a guy who will come off and link the play, certainly. So a different problem for Terry and Ferdinand.
Rio Ferdinand behind Richards. Mathijsen with Joe Cole. It's been good tonight, Joe Cole.
Yeah, he's lacking games as well, isn't it? So this won't do him any harm. And I think, as you said before, England are very, very comfortable at the moment. And the Dutch look average at best here.
It's Oya. Schaars, who's done nothing really. He's come into this game with quite a big reputation as well. Robin. Came off Ferdinand, back to Arjen Robben, who's tiptoeing through the daisies at the moment. He's got a corner too. Don't quite know how he did that.
Yeah, it's good play, good feet as well, but well done, Micah Richards, stuck with him.
Seedorf, out by John Terry. Clarence Seedorf. Ferdinand, just ahead of Huntelaar. Andrew Johnson, Wayne Rooney, Lampard's made a run down the middle, Ashley Cole is near side, Lampard furthest forward at the moment for England. Andrew Johnson there too. Dutch needed that header from Schaars. Joe Cole, Carrick. Ferdinand away from Huntelaar. Tyson, Robin, Jaliens finds Van der Vaart. John Terry. Free kick is given. Van der Vaart just stood in front of Lampard. '69 since England last won in this country. Emmanuelson. Van der Vaart is forward, Huntelaar too. Jaliens finds Lanzaert. Schaars. Well, they might have had the ball, but they haven't troubled England. Emmanuelsen. Seedorf. Huntelaar is on the edge of the penalty area, left arm raised. Jaliens' cross took a deflection, which helped Ferdinand in the end. Dutch throw. Here's Oya. Van der Vaart. Space right-hand side, Q Jaliens is there. Klaas-Jan Huntelaar in the middle. Well, compare that with Joe Cole's cross in the first half.
It might be described as a deep cross. Now, I don't really expect an answer to this, but is this not some sort of record, England not making a substitution in a friendly?
Well, we're halfway through the second half.
This was the Robin, wasn't it?
Started,
just look at Richards, eye on the ball all the time. Very good.
Robin's little tango came to nothing in the end. Joe Cole.
Just thought maybe Joe Cole could have had an extra touch there. It was two against two with him the ball at feet. Rooney and Johnson against the two defenders who were moving as well, the two England players.
Here's Huntelaar. Schaars. Robin. He's going to run at Micah Richards here. Joe Cole's back helping out. Robin. Did well, Richards. Stood up. Emmanuelsen. Seedorf. Emmanuelsen. England keeping Netherlands at bay at the moment. Matthijssen. Wouldn't bet against an England goal on the break either. Matthijssen, that's a better ball. Here's Van der Vaart, who found a good position. Almost every Dutch effort at goal has come from Van der Vaart.
Yeah, he just stole in around the back of Carrick, didn't he? And difficult position for John Terry and Ferdinand to come and adjust to. And you see it, it's just Carrick in the pitch and he gets in on the back of him. And in the end, it's Terry knowing really whether to come or just to wait. In the end, it was wasted.
There's Gerrard. Rooney's chest off. Oh, it was a really important interception, but they're not off the hook yet. It's Rooney again, tried to steer it beyond the goalkeeper, who made quite a straightforward save in the end, Stekelenburg.
But I think just the fact of Gerrard and Lampard bursting into the opposition penalty area made all the difference. And in the end, there you say, created the chance.
It's a foul by Ferdinand on Huntelaar.
Strength, isn't he, Rooney? Lovely ball in to Cole, and then Lampard comes in, and it was a shot, no doubt.
Robert. By Carrick, and this will be chased by Rooney. Andrew Johnson and Lampard are already getting forward. Wayne Rooney for England. Oya in front of him. Kyaljan's back helping out too. This is Steven Gerrard. Cole. Carrick, look how much room Michael Carrick has here. Invitation was there and he very, very nearly took it.
Oh, it was. Great invitation, wasn't it? In you go. Anybody thinking of closing him down? Or maybe. Strike.
That was very close. Actually made his debut, Michael Carrick, for England way back in April 2001, which was only a month after Ashley Cole. Who has 45 more caps than him now. Here's Skaz, Huntelaar. Lampard, Cole. Johnson has just failed to keep it in play.
I think England will make a change very soon, Steve. It's not past the 70-minute mark.
They'll have six at their disposal. But they'll have to come thick and fast now if Steve McLaren's going to use all six. Rio Ferdinand. And certainly in this second half, the inventors of total football have been totally average. Here's Lampard. It's a free kick.
I think you're being kind to Holland. I've never seen a Dutch team that can't pass it as much as these. It's one thing about them, isn't it? Sometimes you look at them and might have this, not have the penetration, the cut and thrust, but they've always been extremely good passers. This team certainly aren't. And you have to credit England many respects for that, stopping them playing.
Sean Wright-Phillips is going to be the first. But it's going to be after the England free kick, which is taken by Lampard. John Terry came forward with a late run. And Sean Wright-Phillips is going to be coming on here for England, and Andrew Johnson looks over to the dugout and he knows what's coming. The number 10 is coming. Andrew Johnson, Mark.
I think the boys in the studio said it all at half-time. I mean, in the second half, he's been playing in a sort of inside left position. He's not, in the games that he's played, Steve, he's still not played through the middle, which is why he's been picked, the reason he's been picked. So he's done well for the team tonight, but in terms of himself, I think it's been a very, very difficult night.
Yeah. Sean Wright Phillips is on. Ashley Cole wins a throw-in for England.
I think the other thing as well about Andy Johnson, if he'd been fit for Macedonia, Croatia, I think definitely in the second game away in Croatia, he would have played through the middle with Rooney off him. It would have been 4-4-2.
He's been consistently unlucky with injury just prior to England games. Now, this is a yellow card shown to Ashley Cole for taking too long about an England throw-in.
Yeah, but it's still England's throw-in.
Yeah. Which is a good point well made.
They're all laughing, all the crowd in front of us here.
Joe Cole with Andre Oya. Wright Phillips, Sean Wright Phillips has played 55 times, mostly as a substitute, it has to be said, since he last scored a goal. His last goal was in his second to last appearance for Manchester City. Yallian's got a footed, Carrick's there for England. Another goal would just take whatever sting there is in the Dutch right out of them.
You're saying they've got a sting in them?
Not sure, Mark. Not sure about that. Joe Cole's got a sting in his foot at the moment. He's picked himself up to try and chase this pass, but he's hurting a little bit at the moment, Joe Cole. Stephen Gerrard's made a good run. Mathieson got his head on it. I don't think Joe Cole will play much longer.
No.
Sean Wright Phillips has fouled Clarence Seedorf.
No reason to run the risk for Joe Cole, is there?
Robin is running. Hunter Lara ahead of him. It's a corner. Ian Robin will take. Oya's come forward. Taken away by Carrick as Denny Lansout was looking to tee up a volley. Emanuelsson. Robin. Oof, tackle right on the edge of the penalty area by Sean Wright Phillips. Van der Vaart across goal! Hunter Lau is close. That's as close as the Dutch have come for a very long time.
I don't think it's a penalty. I think he gets a ball right, Phillips. And also, Ashley Cole did brilliantly because he dummied it. You watch the ball come here, in it comes just, and Hunter Lau comes in for it. You watch Ashley Cole. That's good awareness. Yeah.
Wright Phillips won't keep that in play. Andre Oya.
Kieran Richardson, we think, Steve.
Yeah, Kieran Richardson's going to come on. It'll certainly be for Joe Cole. Gerrard, fouled by Seedorf. England have a free kick, an opportunity to make that change. Here is Kieran Richardson.
Such the vagaries of football. Would his last two starts for Manchester United have been against Crewe and Southend?
Yeah, he's barely been involved for Manchester United. Played only seven times for United this season. And having been initially dropped to the under-21 squad, Kieran Richardson comes on for his eighth cap. Rio Ferdinand looking towards Rooney. Rooney who climbed higher than Oya.
I'm not sure that Oya didn't have the last touch of that.
Well, Rooney thought so.
They don't look bored, do they?
Thought Joe Cole did really well, Mark.
No, he did. He looked sharp and... He just needs a match practice, doesn't he? Everybody knows what a good player is, and a big influence now on this English team.
It's England's throw. Van der Vaart was trying every trick in his book, but he couldn't get away from Carrick.
Two balls on the pitch. It's going to be an England throw eventually. Mattison. That's poor. That is poor. And that's Ruud Gullit, who saw something funny about the Mattison clearance. Lampard for England, looking for Sean Wright-Phillips. Emanuelsson is there. Wright-Phillips. Just needs games, doesn't he, Wright-Phillips? He needs minutes on the pitch and he isn't really getting it.
Can't really see him getting them either, can you, the way Chelsea are now with a very sort of that very tight four in midfield.
Started the season in the Chelsea team, but it was a chance which passed him by and he might have to wait a while for his next one. Ten minutes to go here. England 10 minutes away from a really morale-boosting win. They don't lose very often here in the Netherlands. Here's Carrick, here's Gerrard. Oh, and the offside flag has gone up against Sean Wright-Phillips.
Yeah, just a little bit unlucky. Was he off?
Oh.
You'd have to technically say yes, wouldn't you?
Just needs a break as well as minutes on the pitch.
Yeah.
Andre Oya. Mattison. Scars. Robin. It's been as lively as anyone for the Dutch, Robin.
He's been the only one, Steve, really, that's looked to go past anybody and look to try and create something. Otherwise, it's there's nothing happened from the Dutch, is there?
Huntelaar's done nothing yet. It's Carrick into Richardson. Richardson to Rooney. Jallians to Mattison. And Richardson chased it, but got no reward for his effort. Here's Robin with Richards. Oh, it's a free kick against the somewhat unfortunate, I think, England right back.
I thought he'd done really well. Again, it's the eye on the ball. It makes all the difference. Look, I'm just watching. Just the slightest of nudges, and we know it takes a lot for him to go down.
Danger here for England. Terry away. Rooney didn't really clear his lines. Rooney. Scars was there. England have conceded a throw. Might be a late push here from the Dutch. There's only 8 minutes to go.
They might not as well.
You'd think that the home side would look to finish strongly because they haven't given their supporters much to cheer about tonight.
Well, I don't know if you can hear the lone drum. It's like a dirge, isn't it?
Yeah.
Even the drummer's stopped now.
Emanuelsson to Mattison. There he is. Danny Lanzat finds Oya, the captain. Scars here. Seydorf. There's loads of room on the touch left hand side. Ian Robin is there. Micah Richards across. Seydorf, deflected by Ferdinand, and England will have a corner to defend into the last 7 minutes.
But again, it's football that's played in front of England. It's extremely comfortable for England to defend against.
Dutch want to make a change before the corner is taken. And Andre Oya is coming off, and Jan Fenegor of Hesselink, the now Celtic striker, is going to come on. So there's a defender off and a striker on.
How much does it cost to get a shirt with Venegor Hesselink written across the back?
You don't earn enough money.
Corner kick. Skars is there. Emanuelsson. John Terry got his head on it. Skars with Richardson. It's England's free kick.
What a poor corner from the Dutch. The second touch went back to the halfway line.
Well, last month in Zagreb, we thought England had problems.
Well, exactly. You have to say the future's not very bright, is it?
There he is, Jan Trenegor of Hesselink, winning his 10th cap. 6 years after he won his first. Just had to hurry the keeper. Huntelaar. Richards' clearance is going to be chased by Rooney. Sean Wright Phillips to Lampard. Lampard. Lands out to Seydorf. Klaas-Jan Huntelaar here. It is a Dutch throw, which Clarence Seydorf will take. Huntelaar, Venegor of Hesselink. But Robin's going to take it, so Seydorf can join those two inside the penalty area. Van der Vaart is there too. Ian Robin. Flick on, it might drop in there, and it has, and Holland have equalised, and it's Van der Vaart with an equaliser which they barely deserve with 4 minutes to go. England didn't handle the throw terribly well.
And the inquest has already started about the goalkeeper here, both Terry and Ferdinand are saying, why didn't you come and why didn't you try and help us? It's just a long throw, and it's something that England have used in the past with Peter Crouch, and there's all sorts of problems, and in the end, it's easy for Van der Vaart, but it's such a poor goal for England to concede. It's landed on the six-yard box. Goalkeeper comes and punches, he takes everything, and he deals with it.
Venegor of Hesselink got that flick. Then there's a little bounce off the arm of Huntelaar into the path of Van der Vaart, and suddenly it's 1-1.
It was just a reaction straight away, Steve, the two centre-backs looking at the goalkeeper. And I think Terry said, why didn't you come?
There's still time for someone to get a winner here. Richardson. Rooney. Van der Vaart is racing forward. Steve McLaren is out on the touchline, urging England not to throw this away.
Well, what you say with a few minutes left is you do not concede a sloppy goal from a throw-in.
I have to say from the Dutch point of view that the introduction of Venegor of Hesselink perhaps made a difference. It was his near post header, a little bit of extra height inside the penalty area. But England did not deal with it well. Arjen Robben now for the Dutch. Seydorf. Robin has got in behind Michael Richards. It's another corner, and it's alarm bell time. Mattison is there, Robinson got both hands to it. Carrick completed the clearance.
There's a difference though. The goalkeeper comes, and if he doesn't catch it cleanly, people can react to it. But when you're waiting for him, there's nothing worse.
Richardson flagged offside here. Just 90 seconds of normal time. Republic of Ireland are 4-0 up against San Marino in their qualifier for Euro 2004. England Do not want to throw this away. Robin into the danger area. Terry to Ferdinand. Micah Richards is there. Sean Wright Phillips. Look at Richards go. He'll get away. He's caught by Emanuelsson. It's a free kick.
He's running into the box as well, Micah Richards. He's off. Great play.
Well, you remember the goal he scored in the FA Cup last season, which saved Manchester City at Villa Park.
I remember his interview.
Yeah, we all remember his interview. Garth more than anyone. Now England have four on the edge of the penalty area. Gerrard and Sean Wright Phillips just outside of it. John Terry is the target. Rio Ferdinand is there. This is Rooney. Steven Gerrard for England. John Terry. Gerrard! Gerrard! Oh, good save! Not away yet. It is now Scars forward. Vinegar of Hesselink. Gerrard was very unlucky. Raphael van der Vaart. Look at the space here for the Dutch. Arjen Robben to run at Ashley Cole. Christian Huntelaar in the middle. It's Robben. It's Huntelaar. He's offside. Robinson saved it anyway.
It's the only end-to-end action we've had, and Steven Gerrard did brilliantly. He's touching the penalty area here. Back from Terry. Here, just kids the defender completely in the end. Oh, he just can't get over it enough. What a good chance to win the game this was. That's the hard bit. Just set up a little bit, but contact wasn't great. A bit like his chance in the first half.
Sean Wright Phillips chasing Matthijssen here. 3 minutes to add on. Ferdinand with a header. Gerrard is there. Vanagor of Hesling finds Seydorf. Suddenly it's a barnstorming finish. Lampard. Stekelenburg for the Dutch. Stijn Schaars. 2 minutes of stoppage time to play. Could be the best 2 minutes of the whole 93. It's Lampard. Kieran Richardson ran into Jaliens. Is that a free kick? It is, but it's for the Dutch. Emanuelsson.
Well, I think England would have taken one, wouldn't they, before the start? But given the evidence of the game, we have been the better team. I mean, they were so long 1-0 in front and created the better chances. I don't think there's any doubt about that. And they made Holland look very, very poor. But they've just fallen to this sucker punch.
Right, Phillips got away from Emanuelsson. Rooney here. Richardson is in the middle and Lampard is there as well. And Rooney has beaten Matthijssen. He's beaten him once, he's beaten him twice. Only needed a touch, and I'm not sure that Richardson and Lampard didn't get in each other's way.
Yeah, I think Yallens maybe with the last touch, the right back. A brilliant block in the end. Look, he beats Matthijssen so easily.
Still coming, England. Yeah. Jaliens. It's Ferdinand who wanted it to go out, I think. Rio Ferdinand underneath this for England. Is there a late, late goal in this? It's Rooney. Richardson offside. Rightly so, I think.
I think the other thing as well, just to say, Steve, is that England have got a draw in spite of the formation rather than because of.
There's the whistle. Honours even in the end. We were talking about performances rather than results. In the end, England's performance was the better of the two. They're unlucky not to win the game. Wayne Rooney with his first international goal in more than 12 months from a delicious Joe Cole cross into the penalty area. But a piece of slack defending 4 minutes from time allowed Raphael van der Vaart to equalise for the Dutch. So in Amsterdam, it's the Netherlands 1, England 1.
So a draw for Steve McLaren, clearly not what he would have wanted, having led for most of the match through Wayne Rooney's goal there, but it finished England 1, Holland 1. Alan?
Well, I thought the game was awful until the last 5 minutes. I thought the Dutch were awful until the last 5 minutes. Steve McClaren probably settled for that sort of result before the start of the game. It alleviates a bit of the pressure. You look for positives. The young fullback, I thought, did tremendously well for 90 minutes. I thought the two centre-backs were absolutely cruising. They've got a great, solid foundation for England. I thought that man, Wayne Rooney, did really well at times. I wasn't really happy or convinced with the system. I think there's no problem with the system. I just think the personnel were all wrong. And Andy Johnson, for me, was hung out to dry again.
Yeah, what he's done is, with a system, he's matched Holland up. They played exactly the same system. And whether he's looked at the team sheets beforehand or he's gone in with that system planned, I don't know. But when you do that and match with the team, what you're saying is I have better belief in my players than you do. And for 86 minutes, they got their system right better than Holland got theirs right. Very disappointing, the goal to concede so late on. They could have gone on and won it with another chance for Stevie Gerrard. But it was okay.
I mean, as Alan the game said, the last 5 minutes. After Holland equalised, England played with a bit of urgency, trying to win a game. It actually looked like a side.
Yeah, I mean, I said that in the first half. When we're letting teams knock it across the back and it goes to the full-back, back into the centre-back and across the pitch. And sometimes I don't think that necessarily suits an England team. I think an England team, for the majority of the time, has to go after teams and has to make things happen. Now they were content to do that. They got the goal, and they did okay, and they were working, and Holland weren't really causing them any problems. Yeah. And they were quite comfortable, weren't they? And it was only until the last 3 or 4 minutes that they got a bit upset and uptight.
England are always better when they're playing high tempo. Yeah. We've always said that. And the disappointing thing from an England perspective was absolutely cruising. They've actually, about 20 minutes ago, they started to get it done and were commenting they're playing some half-decent stuff. The game was still a drag, but at least England were sort of playing. And then to lose the goal four minutes from time, you know, you'd have to ask questions with the goalkeeper.
Wayne Rooney hadn't scored for a number of games, about 7 for England, but he got his goal tonight, which will help him.
Yeah, I thought he did. I thought he'd done well tonight. It was ironic. They just changed the personnel over in the system with the three up front and pushed Andy Johnson up there, and Joe Cole came out onto the right, and great run from Micah Richards here. Enables the space for Joe Cole to whip a great ball in behind the defence in front of the goalkeeper, and Rooney and Andy Johnson are there both attacking it, and Rooney gets the final touch.
So difficult to defend against this. The kid makes a great run, he's bombed forward. That little bit of space there, but the ball in is absolute perfection. Goalkeeper can't come and get it. Just needs a touch from attacker or defender, it's in the back of the net, and Wayne Rooney, great goal.
It's funny, Alan, we were just talking before the Dutch scored about how the only time England have conceded a goal in the last 7 internationals was when they played 3 at the back, and a mistake.
And it came, well, it was a mistake, and you'd have to look at the goalkeeper here. We think that he comes in, goes back, and Matt Lawrence is saying in commentary, if he just comes and takes everything, the ball, there he is, he takes a step forward, goes back, the ball there isn't there for long, he comes again. If he comes and just clears everything, all right, you made the comment to me, there's a lot of players in front of him. He's got to come a long way.
I don't think he can come for this first ball.
I think he can come for the
second one there, where he has a think about it, shall I come, and he changes his mind not to. And I think as a centre-back, you know, would know better than I would, Alice. What you're looking for is for your goalkeeper to come and take pressure off.
The 5 and the 6 here, that's what they're looking for. Yeah. Look.
That's the next
and yeah, exactly.
That is actually a minute after the goal. So I don't know whether that's in his mind or not, and thinking, well, I've got to come and take the pressure off. Maybe I should have come and taken the pressure off from the throw-in, and that's just probably forced him to come and get that corner.
If he has got a weakness, the goalkeeper, is it crosses?
England had 2 or 3 decent chances in the second half, first of which fell to Wayne Rooney.
Well, as I said before, I thought he played pretty impressively tonight. He got his goal, but he's got so much strength and ability, and you know, that's a great touch there. And when it eventually comes to him, I think he gets caught between hitting it and crossing it. This is Michael Carrick. This is absolutely brilliant hit, and I think
sometimes you'd like to see Michael do more of this.
Well, exactly. That's what I'm saying. Now, the last time he played, you know, he's got to demand the ball, get in there, demand it, because this is what he can do.
Finds himself in a great position, and the gap just opens up for him.
This is so unlucky, this, because it's a great play. Jared flicks up here, he gets it back from Terry, brilliant at this. Go to hit, come inside. Oh, what a great chance.